Hi, I'm Andrew Wasson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. This time around on the Guitar Blog Insider, we're going to discuss string gauge. Now, you know, as guitar players are developing higher levels of playing technique, and as we get better at things like, you know, playing solos and licks and runs and chording and doing all kinds of different riff ideas, and doing all kinds of different playing styles altogether, different music styles, all that stuff, our string gauge is going to likely change a lot. It's going to evolve. But, you know, obviously there's going to be more to it than just that. You might want different guitars that you own to be strung up with different gauge strings for playing different styles and for doing different techniques. Like maybe if you're playing with a slide, or maybe you're doing a lot of legato work or sweep picking or speed picking. It all depends. But, you know, in this episode of the Guitar Blog Insider, we're going to discuss string gauge and what you'll need to consider if and when you decide to change out the strings that you have on now and maybe head over to a different gauge of guitar strings in the future. Well, it's important to start out by understanding that guitar strings, they come in several different gauges. You know, we name them by their thinnest to the thickest. So for example, a set with an 11,000ths of an inch first string to a 49,000ths of an inch sixth string would be called a set of 11 to 49. So you can have strings in gauges that are very thin, and there's also very heavy or thick gauge guitar strings you can work with as well. But there really isn't any kind of, you know, like a standard gauge or what you might say is a one size fits all. You know, basically the gauge of string that you would choose to have on your guitar depends on a lot of factors, you know, whether it's an electric or an acoustic, a nylon string, you know, whatever, that plays a bit of a role. But after that, it kind of depends upon your preferred playing style, you know, other things you may be doing. You know, however, you know, if you're a beginner player, you might want to consider the whole aspect of ease of playing. So you may want to have thinner gauge guitar strings if you're a beginner, and also lower the string height of the, you know, to the frets, which is often called guitar action. Now, you want to also allow for an easier time of playing the instrument, and you know, choosing a proper string gauge for the level of player you are can be a factor in it all. It's not everything, but it plays a role. And that ease involved with actually fretting chords and scale tones and all that, that will improve, you know, as your technique gets better, and you may want to decide to move up to a thicker gauge of strings. You know, basically, if you have a thicker gauge of strings and the strings are a little higher up off the fingerboard, you are going to get a nicer tone. It's going to be thicker and deeper sounding tone. But that's not to say that you couldn't have thin strings and really manipulate the sound of your amps and some of your effects to generate a really nice tone as well. So like I said before, a lot is riding on how your guitar is set up and the kind of equipment that you're using. That's all going to affect everything to do with string gauge and the kind of sound that you ultimately get. Well, the string gauge that you decide to have on your guitar is going to be a fairly personal thing. And the way you play, how long you've played, the type of guitar that you own, all that stuff forms a direction in helping you decide on what string gauge you can settle on. And keep in mind too that as you move forward in your guitar playing, the string gauge that you use will quite likely change over the years. So for example, new players often stick with the string gauge that came with the guitar they purchased. And if that's you, keep in mind that your guitar came from the store with a particular gauge of string on it, and the guitar was set up at the factory for that set. So this means that you gotta know exactly what gauge of strings your guitar came with, because that will be the starting point from which you would decide whether or not you'd want to continue with that gauge, or maybe whether you would like to switch to a heavier or a lighter gauge. So if you don't know what gauge you have on your guitar right now, then you'll probably have to ask a guitar technician to measure the thickness of the strings that are strung up on your guitar right now and have them tell you. Well, if you're curious as to why maybe certain players might want heavier or lighter gauge strings, you'd almost have to probably ask them specifically why they've gone and chosen the strings that they use. You know, a lot of these famous players, they have really specific reasons and stories even behind why they've chosen their preferences for certain gauge strings. I know I read about Eric Clapton on how he uses string gauge 10 to 46 with his action set really low on his electrics, but he likes heavier gauges on his acoustics. So, you know, opting for, I think it's like 12 to 54 he's using on his Martin acoustic guitars. But, you know, I remember reading too that Stevie Ray Vaughan, you know, just amazing guitar player, amazing tone, he liked those big, heavy strings. He used 13 to 56, I believe. But due to that thickness, you know, when you start learning his stuff, you're going to realize pretty fast everything he's playing is down-tuned to E flat. You know, it's not in standard tuning. It's down a half step. You look at somebody maybe Eddie Van Halen. He's, you know, kind of an interesting guy because he has his own custom gauge set that he works with. He uses, I believe, 9 to 40. And, you know, and that string gauge is kind of funny because it's not a normal, you know, string gauge setup. But again, you know what, it works for him. I remember too, when I was heavy into Zeppelin, Jimmy Page, he kind of was, you know, moving through different gauges on his guitars. I know he used for a while really thin strings on his earlier stuff, and I think he still keeps some guitars on the, you know, sort of like the 8 to 38 string sets, but you know, on other guitars I've read recently, he actually has string sets on them going a little bit thicker. He's using the 9 to 42s. The last guy I should really mention that's kind of really a unique guy is Billy Gibbons from ZZ Top. He likes super thin upper strings. I believe his top string is a 7 gauge, which is like really, really thin, but he has, you know, sort of a regular lower set of a gauge of maybe, I think it's 8, so it's like probably 7 to 38 would be his setup. So, I mean, you know, that's really different again, but, you know, for Billy Gibbons, it works perfectly. So, you know, the gauge that you decide upon is going to be ultimately up to you, and, you know, as you go through different string sets and you experiment, you're going to find what the best gauge is for your particular style of playing. All right, so one of the last things I want to discuss here are what happens to your guitar's setup when you change string gauge. And you're going to need to think through basically 5 areas with respect to your guitar's setup. Now, the first area is what we call relief, and that's the amount of bow in the neck. Truss rods counteract that tension and keep the neck more or less straight. So, you know, increasing or decreasing string gauge may mean addressing the truss rod. Not all the time, but something you want to keep an eye on for sure. Then there's also the nut of the guitar. A lot of people don't realize this, but if you go up a gauge of strings, it's possible that you may need to change your nut and may at least make sure that your strings aren't binding. And if you do go to thinner strings, you go down a gauge, you want to make sure that the string doesn't have a lot of side-to-side movement, because that could definitely affect your tone. Another thing I want to mention for sure in here is intonation, because that's a big one. That's the tuning of your guitar across the whole span of the guitar fingerboard, and believe it or not, affecting that a lot is the size of the string. So changing gauges may mean that you'll have to adjust intonation to keep things sounding as in tune as possible. I have a video on that if you need to check that out. Another area too I want to, you know, mention in here is most certainly if you have an electric guitar with a tremolo arm, a string change to another gauge is probably going to affect that tremolo arm, you know, most definitely actually if you have a Floyd Rose style. Now, what's going to happen is the springs on your tremolo are going to need to be set in balance again against the new string tension, because if you go to a different gauge, you're going to have different string tension. That, of course, is going to affect the tremolo bar, and it's a big factor when you go and do the string changes is you're going to have to look into your tremolo bar if your guitar has one and reset it. Now, finally, there's also your guitar's action. Now, that's the string height of how high or how low the strings are toward the guitar fingerboard, the face of the fingerboard. And what happens is when you go into lighter strings, for instance, you get less tension and your strings are going to feel more floppy. If you have a thicker gauge of strings, then you're going to get more tension, possibly making your guitar feel harder to play. It'll feel like the action seems like it's up higher for you. So, you know, by making an action adjustment, it may possibly help your guitar feel better compensated. And you can do that on an acoustic by changing the height of your bridge saddle. If you have an electric guitar, you're going to have to reshape your saddles all across all 6 strings. So a little bit of work to possibly do if you change your guitar string gauge, but these are things you're going to have to be aware of, because at least one of these 5 things will probably get affected as you change guitar string gauge. Well, I'd like to end the discussion by saying thanks for joining me. If you want to learn more about what I do as an online guitar teacher, then head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for your free lifetime membership. Later on, you can always upgrade to either a basic or a premium lesson package to start studying all the professionally organized guitar courses I've put together for the members of my website. Also, I'd be really interested to hear your thoughts on some of this stuff about string gauge here in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thanks again, and we'll catch up next week for another episode of the Guitar Blog Insider. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.